hits the pitch to Johnson. He gets outside. He's in! Mario Johnson! 2-point conversion! The Warriors are at
home! Unbelievable!
22-point
win!
16 seconds
left!
Look, I got mine. It's fine.
Brian, put the...
You can put your hand.
All right, here we are live. We got probably just about enough for a basketball team. Very special show tonight. The Shrewsbury Special Olympics National Games are going to be attended by a Shrewsbury basketball team for the first time ever, correct? Isn't that what you said? Mm-hmm. I'm going to introduce everybody, and then we're going to get talking a little bit to the coach. I'm going to start over there. Of course, everybody knows Billy, Bobby. They won't say anything else the rest of the show. Nick may say something. I'm not sure. Sitting over here is the assistant coach, Keith Peabody. The head coach, Bill O'Brien. Sitting next to me is players now. Liam O'Brien, Matt Roy, Josh Sargent, Joe Jamrose, and the rock star himself, Ryan Dixon, sitting over there. That's what I was told, anyways. All right, Coach, we're going to start with you. You kind of gave us a preview. How do you get there? How does this happen?
So in the 2016-2017 basketball season, our team qualified in our state Massachusetts tournament by winning a gold medal to put our name into consideration for the National Games this July.
Congratulations.
Yeah, really. That's fantastic. Bill, one quick question before you get into all this. How long has the team been in existence? When did this team start?
So members of this team, Ryan Dixon in particular, started playing when he was 8 years old. So the program here in Shrewsbury has been in existence for over 25 years.
Wow.
Wow.
Some of us have been playing together for less than that, but our core team member was on 25 years, most of us for about 10.
Nice.
All right, go ahead.
Yeah.
So we qualified at the 16-17 tournament to go to National Games. It's our first time as a team attending a National Games tournament. And I'd just like to say that without Shrewsbury Parks and Recreation, the opportunity for this team to compete at the state level and at the national level wouldn't exist. So because of Shrewsbury Parks and Rec, we create the opportunity for 8 different sports programs for Special Olympics athletes in town, and we're very grateful for their support.
And you also talked, Keith, a little bit about, you talked a little bit about the fundraising and the connection with the police in the state of Massachusetts, not
yes.
just Shrewsbury, but...
They have a torch run. Bill was saying that they raise a lot of money. And they also have, another very big fundraiser called the Polar Plunge, where in the middle of winter, all the athletes and some of the coaches, not me, I can't take a cold shower. They jump into the ocean in the middle of winter and
wait a minute. Time out. You guys went and jumped in the ocean?
We didn't jump. We run it right. We don't jump.
Sorry.
Ryan, you go in the water in freezing cold weather?
Yes, I did. Yes, I am. Polar plunge for my first time.
Oh, that was your first time doing it?
Yes.
How cold was it, Ryan?
Was it this year?
Yeah.
It means nothing for him, right?
Guys, I raised over about thousands of money for the Special Olympics Massachusetts.
That's awesome. So you get pledges? Is that what you do, Joe?
That's right.
So you get a pledge, and if you go in and jump in the water, they have to pay you.
Yeah.
I wonder how much they'd pay to have Coach's Corner jump in the water.
I'd pay a lot to see that.
Me too, it's like,
I'd pay to see that. I think Josh was the highest, I don't know who was
it. Josh.
Josh was the highest
fundraiser
for the Polar Plunge. How much did you get, Josh?
I have absolutely no idea. I don't remember.
Close to 2,000, I think.
I wasn't even close.
And Matt, did you do this too?
I... Hello? Yes. So... So, yes, I did, Don, and, I just, like, well, I just work for a local college, so my boss is like, so, at least, you said, Matt, put your feet in, so I'm like, it's like, okay, so I'm like, I just walk towards the water, and put my feet in, and then I'm like, to me, I'm like, that's all said. and then my dad's like, oh, like you just well yeah, like you just went. You just went, and it's like, yeah, it's like, uh-oh, so it seems like now I really need to take a pizza. So, like, I'm like, I do that then. So I woke up, put my feet in, and then I leave. I'm like, okay, I'm like, yay, let's go. It's like, bye-bye. Like, bye-bye, no more.
So just up
no
to your ankles.
No more ice cold water.
Just up to your ankles.
Water.
So, yeah. So yeah, new feet. Yeah, no more pictures. Now, like, Liam, how special is this for you to have your father coaching and to be going to...
Loves to play for
me. Let me tell you something. We all coached in Babe Ruth for a lot of years, and that's why we stayed there, because parents weren't supposed to be coaching, but that's okay. You can be honest with us here.
Thanks for the vote of self-confidence.
How is it having him as your coach?
It's great. He's such a dynamic coach, and he knows how to play the game very well, and... we wouldn't be a team, obviously, without Keith Peabody, because he's been on the team for years, longer than I could count, honestly. But, my dad has been coaching me for youth sports about a few years, but there's always a few years in between as well.
Yep.
It's just great. I love him.
That's awesome. Go ahead, Billy.
No, I was... Oh, never put my feet in cold water. I go up to Hampton and I wait for the little kids to find the title place, and then I put my feet in there. But congratulate you guys for doing that. It takes a lot of guts to run into cold water.
It sure does.
It's only 30 seconds.
It doesn't matter.
30 seconds. Cold.
Yeah.
If we did that, we might have a heart attack. Yeah.
This year, the plunge was the beach where we did the poor plunge this year. It was not even that cold.
Where did you do it?
Nantasket Beach. So it was probably a 50 degree air day. So it was a perfect day.
Good.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, Coach, why don't you give us a little summary of each player here?
Sure. So. We have a great group of players. We have 10 players on our team that are attending the games in Seattle. We have 5 here tonight. And I'll give you just a little bit of background on each one of them. Ryan, I've known for my 10 years being involved in Special Olympics. Ryan's 100% heart. He just never quits. If you need someone to be on the court and give 100%, that's Ryan all the time. Never gives up. Joe Jamros is our big guy. He loves to rebound underneath. He can be all over on the court, knows where to be, knows where to be on offense and on defense, and does a great job for us.
Great give and go.
Thank you. Thank you, Coach.
You're welcome, Joey. Josh Sargent is a speed demon. He's runs track and field for our programs, one of the fastest guys on the team, one of the fastest guys in the state, so he gets up and down the court for us in no time. And next to him is Matt Roy. Matt Roy's our lefty, so he plays the left side.
the strong side.
Remember the Titans. So Matt's a good asset to have on the court, because we can have a strong guy on the left side for us. My son Liam is a little bit of a utility player, but his defense has really come along this year. So we've been really working on that to
Very
create
strong.
Some pressure to turn the ball over on the court. So we've got a great group of players. We're well-rounded. The other thing is our guys are in very good shape, so we tend to run a very fast-paced game. So by the end of the game, we tend to do fairly well if we can continue that pace and we have fresh legs we can keep putting on the court.
How often do you practice?
So we practice. So our basketball season runs from November till about April. We practice weekly. And we play in about six tournaments, and usually a tournament will be 2 to 3 games each time we play. Our big state tournament is you play 2 days, so you'll play 4 to 6 games across the weekend. So it's pretty rigorous, and all of our guys tend to play other sports too. So when we finished in April with basketball, we continued to practice every other week basketball, but all these guys played volleyball or track and field on a weekly basis, so we keep that conditioning going.
When you go to these sites, do you have hotels or do you have host homes?
Sure. So the two-day state tournament, our big state tournament, is a hotel. So it's actually held here in the Worcester area. So Shrewsbury High has often been a venue that we play at. But the local...
This was the first year.
Yeah, this was the first year in a while we haven't played at Shrewsbury.
We had to go to North.
Yeah, we went to North High. Yeah. But usually we play in the Worcester area, colleges and high schools in the area. And we stay in the Marlboro area at a hotel, so it's a bit of a, it's both about the athletics, but Special Olympics is also about social inclusion, right? So it's an opportunity for our players to interact with other teams. Mm-hmm. There's a team from Marlboro who we've become very friendly with, and so that it's that opportunity for those athletes to develop those relationships outside of the normal group of peers they play with, just like you would if you were in high school sports.
It's a good rivalry. It's like a real Marlboro team, and they just want to beat us, and they can't.
How are you guys feeling about the 5-hour flight? Is it a direct flight?
Direct flight, yeah.
Direct
actually
flight out to
actually
Seattle.
It's 6 hours.
6 hours? It's 6 hours? What do you think?
I'll be grumpy. And take a nap. I'd rather stay up all night.
Joey, you are not staying up all night.
I might.
Oh, so you're going? So you're leaving at night?
No, we leave. We're Saturday morning at 6:30.
I know. I don't like it.
3 o'clock in the morning. Wake up. I don't wake up.
I'm sorry. You guys don't wake up at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Liam, quit complaining.
Bring some snacks.
Bring plenty of snacks.
Now, I'm going to ask them, do you run an offense? And I know you play 2-3-D, right? A 2-3 zone for defense. And how about offense? Is it just, do you just go up and call a play? Or do you just kind of cut and pick and rolls and stuff like that?
You do pick and rolls, but we're not really a... we're more of an opportunity team. We look for opportunities that we can take advantage of. Yeah. And if we see an opening of a player, we'll pass the ball to them. And if they make it in, good. But if they don't, we'll just grab it and put the rebound right back up.
Okay.
Right back up.
All right. So you that's how you play. It's kind of freestyle.
Yeah. We have a fairly dynamic guard who plays for us who creates a lot of scoring opportunities for us. He's a very unselfish player. Probably the best player on the team, but he's always looking for the open man.
Who's that? What's his name?
His name's Matt Millett.
Matt Millett.
Yeah, he's a very dynamic
player. Can you remember the other players that aren't here tonight?
Sure, that's a good idea. The other players aren't here are Matt Millett, Zach Englehart, Colin Davidson, Joey Walsh.
And Brian Mills.
Thank you.
Are they all from Shrewsbury?
Most of them are from Shrewsbury. A few from Northborough, though. One from Worcester. Yeah. When the program started, because there wasn't much.
And actually, Maggie Millett is from Spencer.
Spencer.
Oh, great. Good one, Joe.
Yeah, good job, Joey. A good friend of Matt Millett over there, for sure, and teammate. So when the program started here in Shrewsbury, there weren't many other Special Olympics programs, so they allowed athletes from other towns to come in and
to have some kind of connection.
Yeah, to still have that opportunity. Yeah. And that's really, it's about access, right? So if you live one town away, you may not have a soccer team or a basketball team or a golf program. Right.
So that's how they do it.
There is some reciprocity that Special Olympics creates for, you know, creating playing opportunities for athletes.
We had a kid that was on our team, it was at the Mercy Center. And they closed their program down. Yeah. We grabbed him, we can get the.
So it is about inclusion more than anything else.
Absolutely.
It's not just about Shrewsbury. It's about having the kids play, right?
Right.
And you said they all play more sports, correct?
Sure. Yeah. So in Shrewsbury we have.
Are we gonna take a break?
It sounds that way.
Oh, all right. We'll take a quick break. We'll be right back, and we'll talk more about the Special Olympics Nationals coming up in Seattle. Inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, girl, it's pulling me out. You wouldn't believe how we wow shit out. We burn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's turned out. Act up from northwest, east side. Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoked, get it started, get it started, get it started. Let's get it started, let's get it started. In here, let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Let's get it started. Let's get it started in here. Yeah. Lose control, a body and soul. Don't move too fast, people just take it slow. Don't get ahead, just jump into it. Y'all hear about it, the P's will do it. Get started, get stupid. Don't worry about it, people will walk you through it step by step like an infant new kid. Inch by inch with a new solution. Transmit hits with no delusion. The feeling's irresistible and that's how we move it. Everybody, everybody, let's get into it. Get stoked, get started, get started, get started. Let's get it started, let's get it started in here. Let's get it started, let's get it started.
No, they're not supposed to.
And he goes.
They're not supposed to.
All right, we're back here for the second half of the show. And first of all, you're having a send-off Saturday morning at 2 a.m.?
No, no,
I'm just
That was good. That was good. Yeah. Sunday, we could go right to the team.
No, I'm sorry. Yeah. It's going to be Friday at 2:45
at Town Hall. Town Hall that Parks and Recreation is putting together to send the team off to Seattle to compete. So 2:45 Town Hall on Friday.
That's awesome. Go ahead, Nick. Talk about the...
Well, we're talking about best way to help donate and help help provide more support and funds for the for this team as they make their way to Seattle. So
and not just this team, for the whole program.
Yeah,
right, that's right. Right, but specifically to help this team and the program. And Coach, it's at the Parks and Recreation, right?
So the best way,
Shrewsbury Parks and Rec.
That's right.
If they want to make a donation, and we were talking briefly, it was a program that was started by Paula Rourke many years ago, and I just wanted to give Paula a kudos because of her to her efforts. And here you guys are 25 years later, still at it, and now you're going to Nationals. You guys will have her spirit there with you for sure. But so who would they, if somebody wanted to write a check, who would they send it to?
So the best thing to do would be to contact Parks and Recreation, Angela Snell, and to determine the best way to give those funds or donate those funds. And Parks and Recreation can help get connected with our state program. And again, it is through that fundraising that athletes pay nothing to participate, so we're very grateful for any fundraising or contributions.
I was going to ask that. That's great.
There's no cost. But so if you come from town sports or if you come from high school sports, the first time we played, I said, what's the fee? And there's no cost to participate because of all these fundraising efforts. So those dollars are greatly appreciated.
Very generous.
Angela Snell at Parks and Recreation can help you.
All right, now,
thanks to Angela, too.
Yes, thank you, Angela, for all you do. Now, how many people are going to Seattle, do you know?
So from Massachusetts, from Shrewsbury, there's a team of 10 and the two coaches. Massachusetts is sending 50 athletes, 13 coaches, two medical staff, and about a half a dozen support staff.
Oh, okay, so you're all together.
We're going to
be a delegation.
Yeah, that's pretty good for you guys, too. You
get
to hang out with the other guys. That's
very nice people, too, from all over the state.
Is Marlboro going?
Marlboro's not.
Good for you guys. All right.
Sage is going to be mad if he sees this. He's the coach of Marlboro. And we have a great rivalry, and he really he's a good coach.
All right, I got to ask you guys, I'm sorry. What other sports do you play? Liam, we'll start with you.
I play golf, soccer, and track and field.
We need another guy
on Sundays instead of me.
I'm sorry, I'm taken.
There you go.
He's got a contract.
Good answer.
Truth.
Wow.
Matt, what other sports?
Besides now is like, just like what Liam said, I do the whole... do the whole, yeah, I do the whole trekking a field, and yeah, well, there's this softball team. In Shrewsbury, there's like none. So like I'm just like Dodo Worcester for now a softball team and like, and that's like, I mean it's like my first year there was a silver. Then last year, that I adult, I'm like, yay for adult, I'm like, adult all the way, baby! Yeah.
What position do you play, softball?
Outfield.
Nice.
But like, I want to be like, pitcher, but like, that's kind of like the whole, don't, now it's like, I'm gonna take the ball away. It's like, oops, like, no, man, it's like, okay, fine. I'm like,
go to the outfield.
Yeah. Like to put back the ball, and then I'm gonna do what, like, do what Keith don't like, to walk back in the outfield.
I don't like anyone walking. You're running.
Walking and I won. It's like, Keith, I'm like, no. I'm like,
you walk, you run.
Yeah, that's right.
It's a running sport.
All right, Josh, how about you? Obviously, you run. You said that.
Yes, I do. I also do bocce.
He plays bocce.
Bocce.
You could be in trouble, yeah, Bill. Yeah. You're out. We play bocce on Wednesday nights. He hasn't played the last four games. We're 4-0.
Six.
Last six games. Six. We're 6-0. So we could use you.
Oh, really?
All right, what else? You run bocce?
I do track and field.
Okay.
I do the 400 meter and the relay and the run and long jump.
Oh, wow. Nice. Good.
Yeah, I'm the last guy in the relay.
He's a legman. He's a legman. Yeah,
got some speed. Like you used to be.
I'm on the team, and this guy, Liam, is the one who has to hand me the baton.
Ooh. Oh, so you're the third leg.
Yeah. Yes. Okay. Yes. And they
put a lot of pressure. I'm the first leg.
Oh, you're the first leg.
So, like, be, so, yes, I would dash. So, like, be like, me to a Zach, the dad, who is gonna come with us to the USA Dames, but not here. So it's like me to Zach to Liam, Liam to Adolf. It's like boop.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. Yes. The coaches always ask us if we have to do a better job on our handoffs.
Yeah. It's like
they put. And these guys put so much pressure because I have to finish it.
Yeah, yeah.
I have to finish this whole thing, and it's a lot of pressure on me.
You can do it, Joshy.
Yes, you can. They said you can
handle it well.
Yep.
Thank you. And Liam, don't call me Joshy.
Sorry.
Joe, how about you? What do you play?
Oh, I play basketball, volleyball, bocce, and soccer.
Another bocce player.
Bocce.
You got a ringer at the end.
Right now, I'm playing softball with my mom.
Nice,
very good. Oh, very good.
And I'm also a coach for the unified track and basketball team at Shrewsbury High School.
Fantastic. Oh, that's good. That's great. I saw something about that somewhere. I can't remember.
So along the Cincinnati Bengals cap.
Yeah.
So play unified is an element, especially. But sorry to take not to take your time, Ryan.
Ryan, you're next.
It's an integrated high school program on unified sports.
Okay. Yeah. Ryan, what about you? What do you play? Do you play everything?
I am playing basketball.
Basketball.
Soccer. Track and field. Formal track and fielder. I am doing
volleyball.
And I did went to the two 2006, USA Nationals games for Bocce. The ringer. Yes, I did win a gold medal.
Awesome. What do you guys practice?
At Nationals? Awesome.
Ryan, tell me you practice. What do you guys practice?
That's awesome.
Yeah. Where do you practice bocce?
Seniors?
I practice bocce at the Shrewsbury Senior Center.
I didn't know they had it.
When you come back, when you guys come back from Seattle, we're going to get in touch. We're going to set up a match. Our team, all of us old guys will play all you young guys.
They used to have it
at
the
other place. I love that. These two don't even play boxing.
Yeah, well, but he's saying you guys are good.
Well, I used to play bocce. It's like the whole time frame of like bocce slash softball. Yeah,
We used to have a softball team.
So like I just used to do bocce and I'm like I don't know why I'm still like here for. It's like why? So I'm just like bye bye to bocce. Like no more bocce.
They're that good. Really?
Yeah.
It's the truth.
They have a soccer team that.
2 minutes.
We had a training program for this World Games, and we were cross training with the soccer team that was going to the National Games. They came in and beat our basketball team in basketball. We went to the soccer field, and our basketball team beat their soccer team. They are an unbelievable soccer team, too.
The camaraderie must be amazing.
It is.
And you see the same, you must see a lot of the same kids, right, when you go around the state?
Yeah. Sure. Oh, yeah, sure. All the same teams, all the same coaches. You get them. You go around, and all of a sudden you're like, hey, you haven't seen you since last year, how's it going, and how's the team, and all the coaches are fantastic.
That's great.
Well, I'm really excited about this. Is there a website or anything that we can follow the games or something like that?
It's on TV on Sunday.
Yeah. So
is it?
On ESPN or something?
ABC.
No, it's ABC.
Are you guys going to be on TV?
ABC's coming to the whole opening ceremony and ESPN 2 nightly.
Awesome. ABC.
ABC.
ABC. Yes.
That's awesome.
The home of the finals.
Yes.
1 minute.
All right, we got 1 minute.
Yeah,
Coach, as a final thing, I'd like to thank you for what you do, both of you. I know what it's like to dedicate your time, and I also know how excited you must be to be going to Nationals. This is your first trip, too, right?
First trip to Nationals. Yeah.
Where they're going next year.
Where are you going next year?
Oh, yeah.
So in
oh, yeah. We're going to film it.
We're going to Abu Dhabi.
To the World Games
for basketball.
That's unbelievable.
And remember, before we go off the air, this year, when we're broadcasting the football games, come in.
Yes, come and visit us.
Come in and see us. Tell us how you made out.
Yes, absolutely. Please.
All right,
please.
Please.
Yeah. And don't forget, if you feel like you have the ability to donate and help the kids out in their quest for national notoriety, don't forget, contact Angela Richards at Shrewsbury Parks and Rec. Guys, thank you very much.
Great job, guys. Good luck.
Have a lot of fun.
Thanks for having us.
Enjoy.